Blackstone presents The Tattoo Murder by Roy Lewis. This book is read by John Lee. Prologue. Inspector Raul Garcia stared out of the window and cursed under his breath. He was a Mediterranean man in blood and outlook. The scenery in the Pyrenees was spectacular at this time of the year, with the high peaks clothed in snow that glittered and shone in the morning sun, when the sun deigned to shine. But on a late afternoon like this, it was a different matter. The snow had begun to fall some 2 hours earlier, a slight sprinkling at first, whirling and dancing in the darkening air, gradually cloaking the valley, but falling now thick and fast, large, silent flakes clinging to the windows of the hotel room the group had obtained to set up the equipment, and making it impossible to get a view of the house below them on the hillside. He had been warned, of course, the minister, but he was a stubborn, dismissive man, ruled by sentiment and the regular stirring of his loins. It was common knowledge among the intelligence services that he kept several mistresses. It was, after all, a common enough practice in France, where the failure to have at least one mistress tended to be regarded as a serious deficit in a politician. But the minister took the attitude to the extreme. Few of his female assistants seemed to have escaped his clutches, if intelligence reports over the years were to be believed, and in addition to the stream of power-dazed young women who were taken to his bed, there was also the one woman who seemed to have maintained a regular grip on his affections. Garcia had seen photographs of her. Straight blonde hair, an elegant figure, startling blue eyes and a classical profile. She would be at least 40 years old now, Garcia mused reflectively, but the minister was still clearly obsessed after a 20-year affair, and his wealthy but rather more dowdy wife seemed to have accepted the situation with an indifferent shrug. Theirs had probably been a marriage of convenience right from the beginning. Money, married to politics. Garcia broke off from his musing to glare out of the window at the swirling snow again. How is it now? The man seated beside him, with a camera and telescopic equipment trained on the building below them, shook his head, leaned back in his chair and locked his hands behind his neck. His knuckles cracked. He sighed and glanced at Garcia. Impossible, sir. The snow blanks out the scene. Garcia swore under his breath again. He glanced at his watch. The minister would be due in perhaps 20 minutes. Why the hell he had chosen the small town of Vajeles-Gazost for his assignation? Why on earth he had decided to marry a few days of skiing at Cotre with a meeting with his mistress were matters for speculation. Garcia assumed the minister needed to demonstrate his physical condition by attacking the slopes of the Midi-Pyrénées to impress himself as much as his voters as he launched himself at the Cirque du Lys. Perhaps it was at Dagelet-Gazost the minister had first met his mistress 20 years ago, and this was a romantic rekindling of a special occasion. A first meeting of minds and bodies 2 decades earlier. Whatever the reason, the Groupe Spécial Contre Terrorisme now had its work cut out. The electronic chatter had been going on for weeks. Ever since the minister had made his controversial speech at The Hague, surveillance units had been picking up information on the airwaves that suggested a spectacular event was on the way. The information had poured into the coordination offices of Interpol. All the signs suggested that an attempt was to be made upon the life of the minister, and Garcia had been assigned to assist in the GSCT operation. His was a supportive role, of course. He was no muscle man, no AK-47-wielding frontline stormtrooper. There were enough of those waiting elsewhere, here in the hotel and elsewhere in the quiet houses beyond the square. But he was aware the men in charge expected some kind of lead from him. He glanced across the room to where the Pole, Kurzlinski, sat quietly. Their eyes met. In the Polish officer's glance he read a cold determination. They had been together now for 2 weeks. They were different in character. Garcia's warm nature was distinct from Kurzlinski's dour stolidity, but they had come to respect each other as they followed the minister's political dance through Europe. Each event, each location presented its own problems for the GSCT. Surveillance to be carried out, discreet security arrangements to be made. Most of it could be done in collaboration with the Sûreté, Interpol, and with local agencies. Most of the minister's movements were scheduled by...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.